It's true the early bird gets the worm, but that may not be the right situation for you in shed hunting. We'll tell you why this week on Lambbeat. Sure, it's true. Deer can drop antlers in December, in January, and parts of February. But when we are looking and considering what's happening on the landscape, and specifically with deer at that time of the year, we know that that's a stress period in a lot of the whitetail's range. Most times food resources are pretty limited, or in some areas, unfortunately, depleted. You may have a great population through the fall, and then you start to lose deer because you don't have a good winter food supply. But we need to be really conscious of going after shed antlers, maybe just a little too early. Use your trail cameras. Really understand when those deer are dropping, because if we're starting to put a lot of miles on the boots and starting to cover that ground in late January, early February, well, heck, some of the deer probably haven't even dropped. And then two, we're out there adding pressure to those deer, pushing them around, trying to find shed antlers when we could simply wait just a few more weeks right there at spring green up. There's a flush of forage. Their bodies are in better condition to handle that. And quite frankly, it's a little bit easier to find them right as that spring green up starts to occur. Some of these antlers probably get a little bit more sun bleached in contrast with the green up, and they're super easy to find. We have to think of a big scale though when we're going out and pursuing these shed antlers. What is really happening to those individuals? We want each deer in any population as an individual to be moving through that stress period in the best condition possible. So for us as land managers, conservationists, let's be smart and wait a little bit and not get out of the gate until about March timeframe, where most of the whitetails have dropped. Sure, there's gonna be some that hold till April, but majority are gonna be dropping in March. There's a lot of factors out there that really determine when deer shed their antlers. It is so fun to go out and pursue them and find them as they've dropped. And sure, there's gonna be some deer that drop in December, January, and parts of February. But when we look at the majority and when they drop, throughout most regions, that's gonna be during the month of March. But one of the biggest factors is an individual's health in relation to that time frame of post-rut activity, right? They could have a really intense rut, and their overall fitness as an individual, their body condition has been depleted because the stressors of the rut. And if there's not a great late winter food source, then their body is going to begin to decrease in health. Their testosterone is dropping, which is a trigger for them to start shedding antlers. So, although it's fun to get out early and find those sheds, that's an indicator, though, that either your property may not have a great winter food supply if deer are starting to drop early, but also you could have a really intense rut and maybe your doe numbers are out of whack if a lot of deer are dropping early. So there are some indicators out there that we're gonna tell you kind of your population dynamic potentially and the overall health of the bucks throughout your property and in your neighborhood, just depending on when they drop their antlers. Another really big factor comes in the form of weather. Obviously, every winter is completely different. If you get sustained temperatures well below seasonal averages that are longer durations and periods of time, or one right after another, that's going to sharply decrease the individual's fitness, so a buck's fitness, their condition, and kind of trigger them to shed early as well. So you could get that in February, where most times you might not be seen shedding till March in your region or compared to other years. One of the last factors that really has a very big impact or variable into timing of when antlers are dropping is food resources. A lot of times in certain situations, there's not a good food resource during the winter period whatsoever. Lack woody browse, lack small grains like wheat, oats, rye, or grain plots like corn or soybeans in certain areas that are gonna have a high energy food resource. Or potentially their timber does not have a large component of red oak acorns that are lasting through the winter time frame. So the availability of those resources are gonna change every single year, and change based on the winter severity as well. But it's important to kind of have this understanding or knowledge base of where your food supply is if you're an intense land manager, because that's gonna help dictate and tell you annually when sheds are going to be dropping, and then the condition that you're getting deer through to the spring time frame. Individual fitness of bucks is definitely important as we're looking beyond just finding sheds. It has implications as how well they're getting into spring body condition so they can start putting resources as it greens up into antler production instead of recovering their body. So if you have consistently bucks who are dropping antlers late, well into March, late March, early April, that's a good thing. That doesn't mean you're behind the eight ball in finding sheds. That means that those individuals are healthy and they have plenty of winter food supply. They have low stress going into winter. Maybe it was just an off winter. It wasn't very difficult when it comes to conditions. But if you're experiencing antler drop later in the season, that's a good thing and something that we can learn from and try and shoot for if you're on the other side of the spectrum. If you are experiencing bucks who were dropping in early January, mid-January, maybe there's a deficit or something in one of those variables that we talked about, whether it's the winter severity, the food supply, the social stress, that you really want to try to improve on your property. Take all three of those variables into consideration when you're monitoring your trail cameras and determining when bucks are shedding their antlers on your property.